हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज प्लस टू अकाउंट्स क्लास। यस्टरडे वी हैव स्टार्टेड द चैप्टर फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट ऑफ नॉट फॉर प्रॉफिट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। थ्योरी पोर्शन वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द मीनिंग ऑफ एनपीओ, दैट इज द शॉर्ट फॉर्म ऑफ द नॉट फॉर प्रॉफिट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, डिफरेंस बिटवीन द प्रॉफिट सीकिंग ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड नॉट फॉर प्रॉफिट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, एंड थ्री फाइनेंशियल अकाउंट्स दैट आर प्रिपेयर्ड बाय एनी नॉट फॉर प्रॉफिट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन NPO, दैट आर रिसीप्ट एंड पेमेंट अकाउंट, इनकम एंड एक्सपेंडिचर अकाउंट एंड बैलेंस शीट। फाइन, सो इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द रिसीप्ट एंड पेमेंट अकाउंट, दैट हाउ इट इज प्रिपेयर एंड विच टाइप ऑफ आइटम्स आर रिकॉर्डेड इन द रिसीप्ट एंड पेमेंट अकाउंट। ओके, सो टूडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द नेक्स्ट अकाउंट, इनकम एंड एक्सपेंडिचर अकाउंट। ओके, देन लेट्स स्टार्ट। Now, what is income and expenditure account? In income and expenditure account is just like a profit and loss account of any profit seeking organization. Like in plus one, you have studied about the trading and profit and loss account. In that, we find out the profit. But for the NPO, we will find out the surplus, not profit. The difference thing is same. The difference of expense and income is known as surplus in any NPO. Okay, so it is just like a profit and loss account. It's a T-shape account. Two sides are there. This side of debit and credit. And four column are there. That you can write here particular amount and particular amount, or you can write that in debit we will write the expenditure and in credit side we will write the income. Okay, this is the nature of this account, is a nominal account. Nominal account, what is the rule for the nominal account? Debit all the expense and credit all the income. Okay, so you can write in debit side, in place of particular, you can write that expenditure. Here we will write all the expenditure and here we will write all the income. Okay, so this is income and expenditure account. Debit all the expense and credit all the income. You will not write both things. Okay, only one thing you will write, that expenditure and income. You can write this only. इससे आपको याद भी रह जाएगा that in debit side we will write the expenditure and credit side we will write the income. Okay, it is a nominal nature. And one thing more that keep in mind, that income and expenditure account we will record the expense and income only of current year, not of the previous year, not of the next year, only current year expenditure and income are recorded in the income and expenditure account, whether they are paid or not. Okay, like which expense we haven't paid, these are outstanding expense, that also we will write in the income and expenditure account of the current year. And income that we have received and that we have not received, full income of current year we will mention in the income and expenditure account to find out the surplus of the current year. Okay, here we will write the date for the year ending, that we will record of the full year expenditure and income. So that's why we will write the for the year ending, not on the last date. Okay, पूरे साल के जो एक्सपेंडिचर इनकम है, दैट वी विल मेंशन इन द इनकम एंड एक्सपेंडिचर अकाउंट, लास्ट डेट वी विल राइट हियर, ओके, फॉर द ईयर एंडिंग 31st मार्च, व्हिच ईयर इज गिवन टू यू इन द क्वेश्चन। ओके, इन एक्सपेंडिचर इट विल स्टार्ट बाय 2 एंड इनकम इट विल स्टार्ट बाय 5. ओके, नो ओपनिंग बैलेंस इज देयर ऑफ इनकम एंड एक्सपेंडिचर अकाउंट. एवरी ईयर एट द end of financial year we will open this and close on the same date. Okay, and surplus will be transferred to the capital fund, that will be added in the capital fund. Like उसमें आप बनाते थे in plus one में that profit you will add in the capital. Same like this in we will find out the surplus. If income are more than expenditure, then difference is known as surplus. If expenditure are more than income, then difference is known as deficient. Okay? Deficient. Surplus will be added in the capital fund and deficient will be deducted from the capital fund. Okay? So, income and expenditure account is a nominal nature account. Okay? It is prepared at the end of year to find out the surplus or deficiency at the end of year. Okay? It's just like a trading and profit and loss account. Fine? So, after that, features of income and expenditure account that I have told earlier, we have discussed. Nature of account, it's a nominal nature. Debit all the expense and credit all the incomes rule will be followed while making the income and expenditure account. Second is nature of item recorded. Which type of items are recorded? In previous lecture I have told you that there are two types of expenditure and income, capital nature and revenue nature. When we purchase any assets or repayment of the loan, that is known as capital expenditure. And if we will pay daily routine expense like salary, electricity bill, stationery, that are revenue expenditure. So only revenue nature expenditure and income are recorded in the income and expenditure account. Okay? Omission of opening and closing balance of cash. इसमें cash का कोई opening and closing balance is not mentioned in the income and expenditure account. Okay? Only we will record the expenditure and income of the current year. We will not mention any opening or closing balance of cash in the income and expenditure account. Fine. Now next is adjustment. In income and expenditure account, we do the adjustment regarding outstanding expense and prepaid expense. Outstanding expense, I have already told you that all the expenditure we will mention here, whether they are paid or not paid. So we will add the outstanding expense and deduct the prepaid expense. Okay? Same like in income, that our income received, if any income is received in advance, that will deduct. And if it is accrued income means which income that is not received, that will be added in the income to find out the total income of current year. Okay? Now next is record income and expenditure of account only current period. Only current year income and expenditure are recorded in income and expenditure account that I have told you earlier. There will be no place for the previous year income and expenditure and next year income and expenditure account. Okay? Purpose, what is the purpose to maintain the income and expenditure account? To find out the surplus and deficient. कि हमें profit हो रहा है या loss हो रहा है. This is the main purpose to prepare the income and expenditure account. Fine. Now we have discussed about the receipt and payment account and income and expenditure account in very detail. Okay. So next topic of theory, that what is difference between income and expenditure account and receipt and payment account, that you will learn. And on Monday in Viva, I will listen the difference between the income and expenditure account and receipt and payment account on the different basis. 10 points are there. So in Viva, you have to learn. I will listen from you. Okay. So this is the first homework for the Viva. In between video, I will tell you that which type of question I will ask in Viva. Fine. Now, next topic is balance sheet. The next topic is balance sheet. It is same like that any profit seeking organization, जैसे उसमें बनाते हैं, as on date we will write here, and four column are there. This is liability side. Here we will write the amount of liability, and this is asset side, and here we will write the amount of assets. In question we have to prepare the two balance sheet. One is opening balance sheet and one is closing balance sheet. We have to prepare how many balance sheet? In question you have to prepare two balance sheet, opening balance sheet and closing balance sheet. Opening means that balance sheet of previous year. That balance sheet we will prepare on 31st March 2018. It means that same balance sheet of 1st April 2018. Okay, we can write here. हम बनाते 31st March में हैं, but the same condition will be on 1st April 2018 when we start the next accounting year. So its opening balance sheet of 2018 and closing balance sheet it will prepare on 31st March 2018. 19. So we have to prepare the these both balance sheet, opening and closing. In opening balance sheet we will write the assets and liabilities of previous year, and in closing balance sheet we will mention the opening and assets and liabilities at the end of financial year. Okay, what is that then, why we prepare the opening balance sheet? Opening balance sheet banane ka hamara purpose hota hai that assets are given to you, that you will write here. Liabilities are given to you, that you will write here. That difference of assets and liability is capital. So to find out the capital, in not for profit organization capital is known as capital fund. Difference of assets and liabilities is known as capital fund. First of all we will prepare the opening balance sheet, in which we will write the opening assets and opening liabilities, yani assets and liabilities of the previous year. Then we will find out the difference of assets and liability. Then difference is treated as capital fund, that we will write here balancing figure. Okay, what we will write here? Balancing figure. You can write short form. Okay, balancing figure. Okay, difference of assets and liabilities. Then you will prepare the income and expenditure account. Okay, that how you will prepare that I will tell you. Receipt and payment account is given to you in the question, and some additional information regarding assets and liabilities, outstanding and prepaid expense are given to you, same like in previous class in plus one that you have prepared the financial statement, trading and profit and loss account. Okay, same like that you will prepare the income and expenditure account. Okay, first of all opening balance sheet, then income and expenditure account, then you will prepare the balance sheet at the end of year as on 31st March. If it is 2018, then it will be 2019. Okay, here you will write the assets and liabilities at the end of. If we have sale any assets, that we will be deducted from the opening assets. Like here machinery is of rupees 2 lakh, and we have sale machinery of rupees 50,000. Then here we will write the machinery of 1,50,000. Okay, that adjustment of sale and purchase we will do in the closing balance sheet from opening balance sheet. If we have sale any assets, then that will be deducted. If we purchase any assets, then that will be added to that assets. And sale purchase is given to you in the receipt and payment account. If we have sale any assets, then payment it will be mentioned in the payment side. If we sorry, if we have sale any assets, then it will be mentioned in the receipt side. And if we have purchased any assets, then we have made the payment, then it will be shown in the payment side. Okay, so we can get the amount of sale and purchase from receipt and payment account. Okay, from income and expenditure account, say if we have find out the surplus, income are more than expenditure, then it's surplus. Okay, that capital fund that we have found find from opening balance sheet and surplus that we have find from income and expenditure account, these both things we will mention in the closing balance sheet. Here in liability side, we will write here capital fund, this amount plus surplus, that this amount that we have find from here, both will be added and right here in closing balance sheet. If we have find the income and expenditure account deficiency, then that will be deducted from the capital fund. Okay, after that total of both sides should be equal. If both sides are equal, then it means your question is correct. If there is difference between the assets and liability side, it means some mistake are there. Okay, same like in balance sheet, mili ya nahi mili. Okay, so first of all we will prepare the opening balance sheet. What is the purpose? To find out the opening capital fund. Then we will prepare the income and expenditure account. What is the purpose? To find out the surplus or deficiency. Then we will prepare the closing balance sheet, in which we mention the assets and liabilities at the end of year which are having of the current year. Here we will mention the capital fund plus surplus that we have calculated from these both account. Okay, after that the total of assets and liabilities should be equal. This is the full fledged question that will come of 6 mark surely. Okay, so in any not for profit organization, which items are recorded that are different from any profit seeking organization? Iske expense and income jo hain wo bilkul hi different hote hain for any profit organization se. So what are the expense and income of any not for profit organization? Now we will discuss about that. Okay, so let's start. So dear students, now the most important theory portion of this chapter, that what are the important terms that are related to only NPO. Like in plus one mein jo aapne basic chapter kiya tha, so these are the basic terms of NPO. Okay, understand these terms properly. On the basis of these terms, you will be able to solve the numerical questions of this chapter. Okay, so first one is subscription. What is subscription? In any not for a profit organization, the owner is the called members. Kisi bhi club mein, kisi bhi hospital mein, kisi bhi society mein, there are members. They are not called the owner, they are called members. If any member want to be a, any join any not for profit organization, then he has to pay sub monthly or annually subscription fee, jise hum kehte hain, wo deni padti hai. Agar aap kisi club ke member banate hain, then also you have to pay the fee, that is known as subscription. This is the main income source of any NPO. So that's why it will be written in the income side of income and expenditure account. इसे हम कहाँ लिखते हैं? Income and expenditure account में credit side में लिखते हैं. Because it is a main source of income from any not for profit organization. There are so many types of subscription, like outstanding subscription and subscription received in advance. Like any member hasn't pay at the end of financial year 31st March, for when we close the account, that any member has not pay of March subscription. So this is known as outstanding subscription. And subscription receive in advance. If any member has pay of the April month subscription in March, so that subscription of April subscription is of the next year. So it is known as subscription received in advance. Okay, that outstanding subscription is the assets of any firm. Outstanding subscription is the assets, and subscription receive in advance. If any member has paid in advance the subscription, it is a liability, because we have to pay back that subscription to any member if he left the organization. So this is a liability. At the closing balance sheet, we will mention the outstanding subscription in asset side and subscription received in advance in liability side. Okay, and in income and expenditure account, we will mention the subscription of current year only. As I have discussed in the features of income and expenditure account, that income and expenditure account, we will show the current year income and expenditure, total income received and not received both, but only of current year. Okay, so income and expenditure account, we will show the subscription of only current year, that we have received that also, and that we have not received, it means outstanding subscription, that also we will add. And if we have received any subscription in advance, that we will deduct, because it is not of the current year. Fine, this we will discuss in detail when we'll do the question of related to subscription. Okay, next is life membership fees. Life, if any member want to become a permanent member of any club or any NPO, then he will pay the life membership fees. After that, he will not pay. Okay, so this is a capital receipt, this is a revenue receipt, and this is a capital receipt. This we will not mention in the income and expenditure account. Okay, that capital receipt we will added in the capital fund. इसे हम capital fund में balance sheet में add कर देते हैं, like a capital. Okay, what is endowment fund? This is also a capital receipt. If we NPO has received any gift from, like कि हमें इतनी सारी land दे दी है, हमें एक building gift में मिल गई है, that we can use for the increase the income of NPO. Okay, so it will be also a capital receipt. This we will show in the balance sheet in liability side, not as a liability, हमें वापस नहीं करनी है, but as a capital. Okay, we will write in the balance sheet, क्योंकि balance sheet में liability side में we will write the liability as well as capital. Okay, so this we will show in the balance sheet in liability side. Okay, now next term is your entrance fees. If any new member will come in the NPO, then he will pay the entrance or admission fee. This we can treat as a revenue receipt. It's a revenue receipt. So we will show this entrance fees in income and expenditure account. इसे हम कहाँ show करते हैं? In income and expenditure account. Okay? Sometime it's mentioned that treat the entrance fees as a capital receipt. इसको आप capital receipt मानो. Then we will show the entrance fees in balance sheet liability side. In liability side we will show the capital receipt. जैसे loan लिया हमने, that is capital receipt. Okay? जो रिसीव होती है मनी हमें वो रेगुलर नहीं है, दैट इज नोन एज कैपिटल रिसीप्ट. ओके, ऑल द कैपिटल रिसीप्ट विल बी शोन इन द बैलेंस शीट एंड ऑल द रिवेन्यू रिसीप्ट विल बी शोन इन द इनकम एंड एक्सपेंडिचर अकाउंट इनकम साइड. ओके, देन नेक्स्ट इज डोनेशन. समटाइम वी विल ट्रीट द डोनेशन. If it is not mentioned, then we will treat it as a general donation. If we have received simple donation, we haven't, nothing is mentioned that for which purpose we have to use this donation, then it is known as a general donation. Okay, then general donation we will show in the income and expenditure account in income side. But if it is mentioned that donation for building, donation for any main gate, donation for any cycle shed, so if we have received donation for any specific purpose, okay, then it will be shown in the balance sheet liability side. You have to understand these terms and learn these terms that where we will show these amount. Okay, if general donation, then it will be shown in the income and expenditure account. If it is a specific donation, then it will be shown in the balance sheet in liability side. Next is legacy. If any person who has not any children, then in his will he will write that my all property will go for this club or this charity club, this orphan, this old age home. Okay, so this is known as legacy. So this is also a capital receipt. Ye bhi hame routine mein nahi milti hai, har koi nahi deke jata hai. So it will be shown in the balance sheet liability side. Fine. Note down these terms and note down also that where we will show these term in the financial statement of NPO. Okay, subscription, income and expenditure account, income side mein, life membership fees in balance sheet, liability side, endowment fund, balance sheet, liability side, entrance fees, income and expenditure account. If it is mentioned that treat as a capital receipt, then it will be shown in the balance sheet liability side. If nothing is mentioned, then you will shown in the income and expenditure account income side. Donation, specific donation in balance sheet liability side, general donation in income and expenditure account income side, and legacy, it's in capital receipt, so it will be shown in the balance sheet liability side. Next is sale of any old assets. If you have sale any old assets, then that will be deducted in closing balance sheet, as I have told you. Okay, and if there is profit or loss on that assets, agar hame profit ya loss hua hai, that profit or loss will be shown in the income and expenditure account. If loss is there, then in expenditure side. If profit is there, then it will be shown in the income side. Okay, the next is sale of old newspaper, that is regular income, har month sale karte hain, it will be shown in the income and expenditure account income side. Payment of honorarium, outsider agar hum koi specialist bulate hain kisi bhi purpose ke liye, that is called as, usko hum jo payment karte hain, that is honorarium. Okay, so these are the expenditure of any NPO, so it will be shown in the income and expenditure account in debit side, expenditure side. Okay, so you have to learn these all these terms very 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 carefully. Okay, no mistake should be there. Okay, learn this, what is the meaning and where it will be shown in the financial statement. Okay, so students, today your third portion is complete. From tomorrow we will start the numerical portion of this chapter. Okay, thank you, have a nice day.